Can biological organisms be considered quantum systems? Once again, can biological organisms be considered quantum systems? And I think mainstream science will agree that certain aspects of biology could be considered quantum systems. This means that they exhibit properties that can be explained by quantum mechanics, such as superposition, tunneling, and entanglement. One example of quantum effects in biology is photosynthesis. Without photosynthesis, there would be no life on this planet, okay? Photosynthesis is capturing photons from the sun and creating food, basically. The fundamental food, quantum food, which is the basis of all life on our planet. In photosynthesis, plants use sunlight to convert carbon dioxide and water into oxygen and glucose, which is energy. This process involves the transfer of electrons between different molecules. Quantum effects allow these electrons to tunnel through energy barriers. Teleportation, which would be impossible according to classical physics. Another example of quantum effects in biology is the sense of smell, the most primordial. By the way, the sense of smell is correlated with Earth because the sense of smell is carried by molecules. In order to smell, molecules from the environment must bind to olfactory receptors in the nose. These receptors are proteins that contain quantum mechanical effects. Also, quantum effects may be involved in other biological processes, including bird navigation. Birds navigate through quantum navigation, enzyme catalysis, and the origin of life. So, this is what everyone already agrees upon. Okay, once again, photosynthesis, quantum tunneling allows electrons to transfer between molecules in photosynthetic reaction centers, which is essential for the conversion of sunlight into energy. Vision. Quantum effects are involved in the absorption of light by photoreceptors in the eye. I already mentioned olfaction. So, quantum biology is a new field, and my book with Jack Tuzinski and Brian Fertig goes a little further. It says all of our biology is quantum. That's the only way a cell can perform innumerable things all at the same time. Otherwise, it's impossible. Any linear effect is impossible. Not only can a human body think thoughts, play a piano, kill germs, remove toxins, and make a baby all at the same time, while tracking the movement of stars and planets as its own biological rhythms. This can only happen through quantum entanglement. There's no other explanation. Also, the brain works through quantum entanglement. When you have a thought, when you retrieve a memory, when you imagine, when you have any impulse in your body that triggers a coordinated activity, which involves the entire body. For example, I'm speaking right now. Neurons in my speech center are going on and off with each pulsation of quantum energy. It only makes sense, does it? I can't speak without quantum entanglement. I can't even raise my arm, and my genes and epigenetic activity and neuroplasticity are all affected through quantum entanglement. All the principles of quantum mechanics apply in our quantum biology. So don't let anyone fool you into thinking that the mind is not quantum, the body is not quantum, or the universe is not quantum. They're all manifestations of the quantum field. The only difference between regular science today and what is being proposed right now by some biologists who are very cavalierly dismissed as quantum mystics, you know, this is a denigrating term that many scientists, mainstream quantum physicists use for anyone who suggests that the quantum field is self-aware. It has to be, since it is where organization occurs. Check out the data. Is the quantum field self-organizing? Yes. Is it self-regulating? Yes. Does it take unpredictable fluctuations and cohere them into a meaningful operation of our biology? Yes. How do we come up with intuition, creativity, love, compassion, joy? Through, believe it or not, through awareness modifying itself as those experiences. And that modification is a quantum modification. You can also say qualia modification, because ultimately even quanta are qualia. They're qualities of awareness, whatever you see, whether it's a photon or an electron or a Higgs boson or a quark. Some of these are actually invisible and non-material entities like spin, charge, mass. All of those ultimately are experienced in our consciousness. So the quantum field is not only self-organizing, it has to be aware. What is the self that is organizing itself? Quantum biology is the future of medicine, and also the future of our deeper understanding of health span, lifespan, and also a future which will lead us to the inescapable conclusion that we are formless beings experiencing ourselves as form and phenomenon. Quantum biology, the next revolution. Quantum Body, my book with Jack Tuzinski and Brian Fertig. So you can check it out. And thank you for your patience, and thank you for sometimes tolerating my redundancy. But, you know, if you say the same thing from many different points of view, at some point, I think a few people will get it. I hope.